Hello friends, welcome back, and this is Faraz Shaikh with you. And in today's Excel video, we are going to learn how to find the top n values using the dynamic arrays. We are going to use the new functions and we are going to extract those values. And you can check my earlier video and the link is in the below video description where we have did the same technique without using this new dynamic array functions. So let's jump to our Excel file and try to figure it out how can we do it with these new amazing functions. So this is our data set over here, and we have the salesperson, the country and the sales amount. And we would like to extract the top three values of the sales from this data set. So that's basically our n value. So our n value could be 4, it could be even 5, or it could be even 10. So it doesn't matter how the value changes, we want that information to be get extracted. So as of now, we are going to extract the top three values only. Now to get the top three values, we are going to use the large function. So we are going to call large, and this is our array, okay, comma, and the k value is 3. Enter. So we got the third largest value, but this is not exactly what we are looking for. We are looking for first, second, and third. We are going to write again the large, and this is my table array, comma. And the value of the k should be dynamic. So every time I change the value, it should give me that largest value. Hit enter. Now we are going to compare this value by these columns. Yes. So we are going to say less than or equal to, check it whether in this columns. So it is going to iterate on every row, check the criteria and return us the value as true or false. Yes. So these are the true values which we would like to extract it. Now let me change it 5. Yes, that's worked great. 6. And again, we'll put it to 3. Since we know that which are the true values we would like to extract, we are simply going to call the filter function. Yes. And in that filter function, the table array is the entire range of my data, comma, include. This is the logic what we have built it over here. And in case if it is empty, we will say no match found. Close parentheses, enter, bingo. That is what we needed, my friends. So I'm just quickly going to do the formatting. Okay, that's looks wonderful. So let us call top 5. So we have it over here, top 5. Let us check top 10. Oops, we got the spell error. Note, my friends, whenever you're constructing the dynamic array formula, there's no obstruction in the range where you're writing the formula. In this case, on cell F11, we have some spaces. So let's remove that, and we got the data over here. And one more thing about the dynamic array formula, it will work on the first cell and then it will spill out all the information to its relevant columns as we have it over here. So if you try to go and edit the formula, you must have seen it has grayed out. So if you need to change any formula, you have to go to the first cell where you have written the formula. Now, if you have seen, my friends, the numbers which are there, the sales amount, those are not in descending order. So we will just apply another function which is called as a sort. This is my array, comma, the sort index. So sort index is 1, 2, 3, third columns. Based on the third column, comma, it should be in descending. Close parentheses, enter. So we got all the largest value being sorted into the descending order. So now let us go and add some new data out to our data source. And this is our data source over here. So I'm going to press it as Ctrl T. I'm going to convert it as an Excel table. So my range will automatically get updated. And I'll say, yes, my table has headers. So this is my sales table. It's always a good habit to maintain your table name so that when you have a lot of filtering or you have to make a pivot table or something, then you know exactly where is your source and from where you're picking it up. So let us add this new data to our data set. Yes, this is the data. Control X. Now just watch it, my friends. Control V. These are the top three salesperson for the respective countries. Now let us change the value to 5. Wow. That looks cool. Now let us add the serial number to our list. Insert, and we are going to say SR number. Like to keep the same formatting over here. So we are going to call the sequence function equals to sequence. And in the sequence, we are going to call count A. So count A and the pound key. So when I press the pound key, Excel automatically understand it's in dynamic array range, close parentheses, and then I'm going to divide it by 3. The reason why I'm going to divide it by 3, because it has selected my 3 columns, so I have to just divide it by 3 to make it 1, and then as it goes on adding as a 6th number, then again it will divide it by 3, so it will make it 2. Comma, columns, no columns here, start 1, comma, step 1 every time, close parentheses, enter. Yeah, we got it. So let's check it again. Number 10, wow. Number 4, that looks good. And now even you can add the data bars to this. So just make sure that you select the sufficient range. So I'm going to select the range till here, and we are going to go to data bars, and we are going to see this gradient field. Just make it a little bold. I'm just cleaning up the data so it looks nice. And now again 4, 10, and again 7. So that's all for today, my friends, and I'll be coming up with more amazing dynamic array videos. So stay connected to my channel, subscribe it, share it, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for the latest updates. And do let me know in the comment section, what do you like about this video? What do you like about the dynamic arrays? I would love to hear from you. So signing off for today, your friend Faraz Shaikh from FShaikh Excel Master. See you soon. Happy learning.